Hello, my name is Jeff Wiesman. I am a tech operations manager over here at the search agency. My colleague Abby has written a great article on trigger groups in Google Tag Manager, and we thought it'd be a good idea to make a supplemental video that goes along with this blog article. So, quick overview on what trigger groups are. They are a simple way to group existing triggers into a new trigger. So some of these examples would be tracking a highly engaged user, being defined as a user who, if they were on our site, they scrolled through half the page, clicked one of our video views, and then clicked our Contact Us button. And this would allow us to see if video views are leading to Contact Us form fills. Another example would be if you wanted to track user engagement with a form here. So you could set the trigger group up to where if a user interacts with, say, three of these form fields, the tag would fire. Now, what this could do is it would allow you to see the number of users who engaged with the form, and if you had a separate trigger on form submission, you could see the difference between form submissions and see if there's any kind of drop off there. Which could lead to maybe reformatting the form, those kinds of things. Another quick example would be if you had an e-commerce conversion funnel and it's a dynamic page where the URL does not change, and say you had, three required steps out of a total of five steps, you could set up a trigger group to where if the user hits those three required steps, you'll fire the trigger. So we'll be doing a deeper dive into the first example of tracking a highly engaged user. So we'll move on over to Google Tag Manager over here. And first I'll go through the implementation method prior to Google releasing this trigger groups feature. So what you would have to do is you would have to store a cookie value for the 50% scroll and a separate cookie value for the video view. So here I have the cookie script. So what this does is it just writes a cookie called user scroll and it sets the value as true. Same thing with video view. Similarly, we have video view cookie with the value as true. And what I've done is I've appended these to our existing 50% scroll and existing video view conversion tags. So if I click into the 50% scroll here, we utilize tag sequencing. So when the 50% scroll trigger is met, it fires the conversion tag and then it also sets this 50% scroll cookie. In addition to that, we would have to go over to the variables section here and set up two custom variables. So what these variables do is they read the cookie name that we just defined and pulls in the value. So if the cookie is set, the value it will show is true. This allows Google Tag Manager to read these values at a later event on the same page to see if those two conditions have been satisfied. And now the final piece to the legacy implementation would be coming into this cookie-based tag, we would have to add the final condition, which would be clicking on that Contact Us link, and then also creating two additional constraints where if the video view cookie is true and the 50% cookie is true, then the highly engaged user tag will fire. So I can do a quick walkthrough. Let me unpause this tag. And I will pause the trigger group version that we will be getting into next. I'll come in here. I will clear our cookies from the site. Refresh the page. Need to refresh GTM first. Okay. Okay, we have our GTM preview here, and I've opened up the Chrome Developers Console, and on the Application tab, under the Cookie section, you can see all the cookie values that are here. There's nothing set yet for video views, and there's nothing set for the user scroll yet because we haven't actually performed those actions. The next thing we want to do, since clicking on that Contact Us link will actually redirect us to the contact page, I'm going to utilize Gtm Sonar, which is a really, really nice tool for suppressing any kind of redirects that are click-based, link-click-based, or form-submit-based. It's more of a developer's type of tool that helps with debugging. So you can see all the values and see the conversions fire without actually redirecting. So we'll switch that on. And now I will do the 50% scroll. And we've now hit that scroll depth. So we'll check for the user scroll, and the user scroll cookie has been written and the value is true. So the next step would be clicking on a video view. So we will play this video, and you now see the YouTube video event fired here, and we will double check the video view cookie, and we can see that that also got written as true. So the final step to complete this highly engaged user tag through the cookie-based method would be to click the Contact Us link here, and we can see that the highly engaged, here we go, highly engaged cookie-based tag fired. So that was the old method of extra steps. It requires writing cookies to the user's device. Through trigger groups, it makes it much more simple. If we pop back into Tag Manager here, I've already created a trigger group for that exact same scenario. So I'll go ahead and pause this cookie-based method, and we'll enable the trigger group method. And looking at the actual trigger group itself, actually first I'll show you how the trigger is created. So you would just go into the triggers section, you would click the new button, you can name the trigger whatever you need to, click the trigger configuration, and trigger groups are now down here at the very bottom. So you would click into that, and this is your basic configuration. You click the plus sign here, and now you have a list of all your existing triggers for the GTM account. So you can combine any number of triggers here to create your trigger group. Now I've already created this, so I'm going to open that up and show what the final product would look like. So here we had our existing YouTube video engage tag, 50% scroll tag, and contact us link click tag. So I grouped these three together, and then another helpful feature is you can also set additional conditions here. For the sake of this, we only want this to fire on the home page. So I added homepage URL equals our homepage. This prevents this particular trigger group from firing on any other pages because that's all we want to do for this sample. So we'll go ahead and refresh GTM, come back over to the TSA site again, and since this isn't a cookie-based tag, we can close the developer's console. It's not needed. So we will do the first action. They don't have to be in order, so trigger groups, they can fire in any order. It doesn't affect the triggering at all. So the first thing we'll do is we'll click a video. We'll play that, and you can see the YouTube video event fired there. And then we'll do the 50% scroll. So scroll depth has hit 50%. We'll switch on the GTM Sonar link click again, and we will click our final step, which is the contact us link. So now here we see that the trigger group event fired, and here is our highly engaged user trigger group. So much easier implementation. Doesn't require any kind of cookie storage or anything like that. One major caveat to it is all of these events need to occur on the same page. So at this time, trigger groups cannot span multiple pages. So in our example, the video and the scrolling and the contact us are all separate events that occur on the TSA homepage here. And that's pretty much our overview on trigger groups. Over here at TSA, we'll be doing a lot more of these videos. So if you have any suggestions on analytics or Google Tag Manager or any questions, feel free to just reach out and hit the comments section of the blog, and we will get back to you. All right, thank you.